Welcome back to Close Up. It was a very good election night for Democrats running for the State House. They won majorities in the House, Senate, and on the Executive Council. One of the Senate seats that flipped from red to blue represents Nashua and surrounding communities, where the incumbent was defeated by Melanie Levesque, our final guest this morning. Congratulations, Senator-elect.
Thank you, Adam.
So tell us, when you're out there on the doors talking to the voters, what was this election going to be about? Did it seem like people were upset about what was going on in Washington, or were there state and local issues? What was driving them to the polls?
I think it was both, very much about what's happening in Washington and their concern about the tone and tenor. So that was an issue, but when we talked about particular issues such as education, healthcare, energy policy, and just decency in general, people were really concerned about all those issues.
A lot of you and your fellow Democratic senators-elect already have some state house experience, so you'll be able to hit the ground running. You've served three terms already in the House. How would you describe your approach to politics?
Well, I believe it needs to be collaborative and working with Republicans and Democrats, but it really starts with listening to our constituents. What do they need? What are they looking for? And getting their opinions, not just on what we should do, but also how we should do it.
So obviously, as you mentioned, it's going to be divided government and people are going to have to work together, a Republican governor, Democratic legislature. Governor Sununu has shown he's not necessarily an ideologue. He's open to changing his mind sometimes. But do you think Democrats should move ahead with their own agenda, kind of in a damn the torpedoes kind of way? Or should Democrats be looking to work with Governor Sununu to find out what he might sign to get something that goes into law rather than gets vetoed?
Well, I think we need to do both. There are things that are very important to us as Democrats that we need to pursue, but we also need to focus heavily on what we can do together, because we do need to make progress, but we need to continue to push for things that are important to us as well.
So tell us, what is on the agenda, at least for you, Senator-elect Levesque?
Well, you know, I have a lot of different concerns. Education is very important to me. I want to maintain the public funding for our education, for our public schools. I know a lot of great homeschooling parents and homeschooling kids, people that use private schools, but the funding must stay with our public schools. So that's one of the areas that I will stand up and defend. Healthcare, also very important. And the environment, I'd like to see more renewable projects brought into New Hampshire.
You served in the legislature there when Democrats took over back in the last decade. What are some of the lessons you take with you, perhaps, from being able to stay in the majority? Because we see in politics now, it's like a party wins and then suddenly it's gung-ho, and maybe voters think there's some overreach. So what are some lessons you've learned in those terms in the State House?
I think it's about conversations with our voting public. We need to stay engaged. We need to make sure all the stakeholders are brought in with us when we sponsor a bill, when we push for legislation, and also communicating the good work that we do.
So your victory is historic. When you're sworn in, you'll be the first African-American state senator in New Hampshire history. What does it mean on a personal level to achieve that first?
Well, on a personal level, I will say that we all need to have role models and mentors. For me, my mom was my first role model. But as an adult, having met Representative Jackie Witherspoon when I was an activist, a community activist, it helped me to understand that I could be more than a community activist. I could be in state government. So I'd like other people to be able to see that as well.
Absolutely. And certainly communities, and particularly Nashua, growing more diverse by the day. What are some things that New Hampshire needs to do better when it comes to diversity?
Well, I think being inclusive is very important. I think that we as a minority, we really need to not look at being a minority as an obstacle. It really is a plus. It's an opportunity to share your difference with other people. So getting involved in different community groups, that's how people get to know who you are.
Mm-hmm. Have you encountered problems at the State House before on this front? I mean, at all?
No. I would say no. People have been great. The State House is very civil and very respectful.
And do you think that's going to be an emphasis moving forward, not necessarily having to do with racial issues, but given the tone of things going on in the country, that this legislature is going to want to set a civil tone?
I've been in office for 6 years, and every term it has been civil. So yes, that's the way that we want to proceed, working together, working with civility and decency.
All right, Senator-elect Melanie Levesque, we'll see you up there at the State House.
Thank you so much, Adam.